really inspect because I wanted to see what the situation was. Tema lang, sana matuto naman ang tao. Much as possible, it will be up to the school to decide what they kung kaya o hindi. Siguro yung iba mapipilitan, they will conduct classes outside of the school building, makapangklase lang. Tingnan natin. They will ganyan naman, nasanay na tayo sa pandemic. Kahit hahanapan natin ng paraan para magkaroon pa rin ng pasok.
Anong guidance niyo sa DepEd?
Ha?
Anong guidance niyo sa DepEd?
Yun, gawin nyo lahat. Buksan yung pampagpasok, gawin nyo hanggat maaari kung kaya nyo buksan. That's the usual, ano, hanggat maaari, open the schools and conduct classes. But there are areas na hindi talaga pwede.
I have to really inspect because I wanted to see what the situation was. It's really different listening, reading the piece of paper than actually seeing it and seeing what people have to go through. So, Valenzuela has the usual problem. Talagang base niyan eh. Lagi nababaha ang Valenzuela. But na marami na silang flood control, pero nasa pawan itong sa dami ng tubig. So we have to relook, we have to re-examine some of the designs of our flood control. For example, this was not the amount of water was not as bad as Undoy, but the effect was greater than Undoy. Mas malaki ang baha, mas maraming nabaha na lugar kaysa sa panahon ng Undoy. Mas marami tayong flood control ngayon kaysa noon. Pero climate change, this is what the effects of climate change are. What we have seen is that one of the most important parts that nagka-problema was that navigation gate that we went to na nasira because binangga ng isang barko basta hindi sumunod sa instructions, sinira niya. That is why the boat is still 80% underwater. Malabon the same, Valenzuela also. So we have to really look into that sort of thing. Yung pumping stations natin marami na. Yun, nakaproblema lang, sana matuto naman ng tao, huwag na ko yung bagtayong nagtatapon ng basura dahil yung basura, yun ang nagbara doon sa mga pump natin. Kaya hindi kasing effective na pwede. Naginabotas yun, 81. In Valenzuela, I think they have 32. So marami na yung pumping station. Pero talaga, you have to put it somewhere. So yesterday, 12 o'clock was high tide. Nag-block nun, nag-high tide. Nagsabay-sabay para matakas ang ulan, tapos nag-high tide. So, at least now I'm very clear about what the situation is. I'll be going to inspect all the other areas when we can travel to see what else is needed in the other parts of the country that suffered flooding. When I get back to the office, I will be putting together now that I know what the situation is, where the areas are that need the most, we will be putting together already the release packages for the LGUs. Because here in NCR, not only NCR, in Region 3, in Calabarzon, NCR, marami nang tumawag sa akin kanina umaga pa. So we'll put that all together so that we can go to DBM and tell them to release this already para magamit na ng ating mga local officials. Alright? Okay. Thank you.